So we had gone up to Bethel Ridge. We were camping in the area, so we decided to go explore Bethel. The snow had just melted recently, so we're just below snow line. And lots of rain, lots of runoff, made it really sloppy and a lot of fun. Now, at this point on the trail, there are only three of us left. We started earlier. We'd had someone on a motorcycle, but it was raining really hard. He got cold and wet, so he went back to camp before we got into any of the really challenging stuff. But on this trail today, there are three of us. There's me. I'm driving a 2019 4Runner TRD Pro. It's got a small lift. It's 33-inch tires, mud terrains. They're the Geolander MT-003s, and just love those tires. I've got them aired down, really far. I'm down to 12 PSI right now, so you can see them flexing here on the trail. Also, we've got a guy driving this really nice second-gen Toyota 4Runner. This has got a 350 Chevy in it. The tires he's running, well, he's got some IROC 37s, which are just great on that truck. He's got it geared nicely. He's done a ton of work with this truck. It is a very purpose-built vehicle. And we're also running with some guys that are kind of new to off-roading. They've got themselves a pretty stock Jeep Cherokee. So what you'll see is the 4Runner kind of take turns being in the front so that we can be able to pull him out of trouble, either winch him out or use a kinetic rope to get him out of trouble if need be. So this little Cherokee, actually, kind of a fun little side note here, he's got some Goodyear Wrangler ATs, and he's got them fully aired up, like 35 PSI. And through most of the trail, he hadn't realized that he was still in 4 high. So he was 4 high and 35 PSI through most of this trail, and just putting his accelerator to the floor and going pretty much everywhere we did. It was really fun to watch. He took he took some cutouts and went around some of the more challenging stuff. But it was just a lot of fun to see him out there and just kind of getting his truck dirty and figuring out, where the four-wheel low selector is. And we talked about, did he want to air his tires down, did he want to, so it was a great learning experience for him. In fact, you're going to see him right up here, still in 4 high, not realizing he's in 4 high, and he just literally just had to floor it to get up that little side trail here around the down tree. Come on, see if you can see.
Nice! Blank out, throttle out, baby.
And I'm driving in this just super plush, amazing 5th gen TRD Pro. Heated seats, like super comfortable. Not like my 1972 FJ40. Very different vehicles. And I was kind of playing around with some of the different off-road options on here. So I've got this electronic rear locker, so it's selectable, I can turn it on and off. Also playing around with the A-track system, which locks up the front.
Oh, that was badass. Should get some speed.
Needless to say, it took a lot to get my truck clean when I got home. Whenever you play in the mud, you have to do the maintenance, right? You've got to go through and clean out everything from underneath, make sure you don't have any water in your breather tubes, make sure you're check your fluids. It's a pretty big thing. So it took a little bit to get everything cleaned up, but it was worth it. It was a great run. the guys in Jeep are, they're really cool. They're both in college. This is one of their first times driving off-road. They've come up with us before, but now they both have their own Jeeps, and they brought their white Jeep on this run. And just, it was really cool to see them kind of like getting into it and exploring, you know, this whole new off-road thing. So it was fun to watch them kind of get some of their first experiences here, especially like just getting sideways on the trail is pretty exciting. Playing, you know, there's deep ruts here, and there's some pretty cool off-camber situations. And right here you're gonna see he gets stuck, and when he is going forward and backwards trying to get himself over this little obstacle here, you'll notice that here in a second he's gonna throw it in reverse pretty hard, and he actually packs his exhaust with mud and it stalls out the Jeep. So you'll see that here in just a second.
Joe, I have a kinetic rope. You could just literally pull him. You don't need to use your winch.
And here Joe and I are back and forth on our CBs talking about, you know, best steps, how to get him unstuck. Joe's got a winch on the front of his truck, and I've got a bunch of recovery gear in the back of my truck. And since I'm behind him, I just thought it would be easier to grab a Yankum kinetic rope and just pop him on out of there. And you're going to see here, right about here, is where he packs that exhaust pipe full of mud and kills the engine.
Off that ridge, drive and go.
Go to the right.
His car just died?
Oh, yeah. No.
So, I got my son Colin, tossed him the kinetic rope there, and Joe's kind of assessing the situation, and we're kind of directing Colin to look for the anchor point, something we can tow from, and couldn't find anything. So I actually had a anchor point that we can put into the receiver hitch. It's a rated
cool, I'm in.
All right,
here's receiver for the for recovery. It's not a ball hitch. It actually has a the proper connection.
Whoever owns this Jeep owes me a beer.
Big shackle connection that goes into your receiver hitch, which is designed for recoveries. So I've got Colin down there playing in the mud, connecting the kinetic rope to a soft shackle, which is then connected to the recovery.
This
there,
is correct way to do soft shackle?
Trailer hitch. So. He's down there. I would have been in and out of there very quickly. I don't know why he's playing in the water, but
that's in.
He was. That's a thing. And here I am in the Toyota 4Runner, just getting myself positioned so I can just do a real quick reverse, just back him right up and yank him out of that little mud hole. We just need to get him clear so we can evaluate the situation. We're pretty sure at this point that he's just packed his exhaust with mud, but we're not able to see it. So we just got to pull him out of the mud hole first. So that's what we're about to do. And now I've got Colin down here, since he's already wet, looking for my tow point, which is right next to the skid plate. With a soft shackle.
The ball.
Really should be.
All right. YouTube videos to get me out of this one.
Okay, let's put it in neutral.
Okay, move out of the way. You ready?
Yeah. And from here, it's just a very nice, steady, safe pull. It doesn't need to be crazy. It's not that deep of a hole. So we just literally want to, like, pop him up and out of that little mud hole, get him into a good, safe place where we can evaluate.
Go left, left, all the left. There you go. You got to get out of that rut.
Oh, shit.
And here's where that Jeep takes a shit. Right on the trail. Slow it down a little bit so you can see it.
That was funny.
Okay, what happened?
It went boom!
And the big old dude, that thing was constipated, man. It had to let me go.
After that, the Jeep started up, no problem. He drove around the obstacle, smart, and we carried on. Here it is from another angle. You can see Joe giving him some guidance, kind of being a spotter, helping him around some of the deeper ruts up into an area that's a little easier for him to drive through. Again, he's just got some all-terrain tires on there, and they're street tire sized. He doesn't have much of a lift or anything on it, so he needed just a little guidance to get to a place where he can bypass this deeper mud hole. Decided, however, just to drive right on through it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And come back and subscribe to see more of our off-road adventures. Thanks a lot.